Can I call him up though? So he can set up.
Will the first person, first group on the list please come up to the podium?
Yeah, so after we get him set up and ready to go, we're going to start presentations. And as you can see, these are going to be live streamed, and your friends and family can tune in. But we request that all of you do not watch this live stream from your computers, one, because it's right here, and two, because it's going to use up our bandwidth, which we can't really afford to give up right now. Thank you.
Can we move the mic stand? Can we move this up?
All right. He needs it on his...
You need to unplug your power. It's like...
Promise it, like, just like unplug it really quickly. No, he doesn't need a charge right now.
It's okay,
you don't need a charge right now. He has battery. It's a laptop.
Yeah, I can't unplug it.
It's going through that wire, so I can't move it. Like, there's no slack on it.
It's a really long cable.
Can I start?
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Isaiah Isaac, and I created the app ThinkIt. It's not going. Okay. ThinkIt is an iOS and Android app where entrepreneurs or just normal people can share their ideas with the world. No. You can make money off of it. How many of you are familiar with the show Shark Tank? So it's that sort of concept. As a young broke person, I'm always looking for creative ways to find money. Fortunately, most of the websites are scams, so I took it into my own hands to create a free app, a scam-free app. I'm sure most of you guys like free money. Sure, you're like, free money, lol, it's free, it's probably another scam. If that's what you are thinking, you are wrong. The way you can get money is with one simple step, ThinkIt. All you have to do is think of a brilliant idea, and if enough people like it, app creators and companies will look at it, and if they think it's a good investment, they will chat with you. When they chat with you, they can make an offer. For example, they will own 25% of the idea, and you will get 0.05% of the overall profit. So if this app gets big and they make $1 million, you will get $50,000, if that was the case. Yes, it is a social media platform. Although it may not seem like one, you can share your ideas with friends and other social media platforms and make money while doing it. So I'm giving you guys a little preview of what the app will look like. So if you have an account, you can enter your username right here. But if you don't, you can click create a new account. And then you can sign up. So my name is Isaiah. And my username will be Isaiah. And my password will be Isaiah. So then I can sign up, and then it takes me back to the login screen, and I put in my username and my password. and it takes you to the first tab. The first tab is the input your great idea tab. This is where if you have a good idea, you can put it and you can put it on all the details. But since I have a short amount of time, I'm just going to put a small idea. So my idea will be the app Thinkit. And when I click submit, it takes me to the next slide. And then when I go down here, it'll be a feed like Instagram. And you can like it. And once you have your post, you can go on your profile. And when you're on your profile, there's a really ugly picture of me. You can put, you have a bio and all of your works or ideas below. I'd also like to give a thank you to my mentors, because this is my first time coding anything. So they helped me a lot.
All right, that was a great job from the first presenter. And so now can we have this next team come on up, the next team in order, which I'm trying to pull up right now. All right, can we have Team Smashers come on up? Also, a quick note, guys, we need to keep the presentations really short so that we can stay in time, because we have a lot of teams to present. We have a lot of things to do. So if you guys could keep your presentation to 1 to 2 minutes, that would be great. And we're going to have to cap you off at 2 minutes if you go over time. And also, we're going to announce teams that are on deck, which means they're going to be hanging out over here. We're going to make sure we have the adapters and everything, and you're ready to go so we can move quickly. So on deck right now is Team Adamax.
So I know most of you guys have probably heard of the game, so Super Smash Bros. Brawl, right? So this kind of looks like it, except it's a two-player version, and it's in the web browser. So like, for the people who can't afford like a Wii U or a Wii, can play the web browser version. So then, basically what we did, this is completely made in JavaScript, and it's actually like, I learned it 3 days ago, and he learned it like today. So, a couple of main components to our game is the fact that we have gravity, so you can demonstrate it. So when you jump up, you see there's a double jump, and that's based on velocity. So what that is, it's basically gravity. So a negative velocity would mean that the object is moving upwards, and then a positive would mean it's going downwards. So what we did was we binded a couple of keys to, so if you press the up arrow key, it would add a negative velocity to one of the objects, so it would move up. And then we had another variable, variable jumps left, which would mean that since we set the jumps left variable to 2, every time you press the up arrow key, it would subtract 1 from jumps left, which would mean that after you jump twice, you can't jump again. And Jerry can explain another feature of our app.
So we tried to make Smash, and it's like a prototype, so we call it Bouncing Potatoes. But what's cool about it is if we press slash, it shoots like little missile things, which are like sprite rectangles. And how we used it is we used arrays and a for loop, and arrays let us use like infinite amount of little sprite rectangles to shoot out. And as the condition for the for loop, it would move the rectangle plus 10 to the right. So that's how it shoots. And so far, only the red potato can shoot, but it's like a work in progress. Yeah, thanks.
All right, great job by Smashers. And the next team is Atomax, and on deck is Team Hummingbirds.
Alright guys, so how many of you have taken some like AP chemistry or any college level chemistry course? Then if you have, then you would probably be very much familiar with precipitation reactions. So let me give this to Abel so that he could explain to us what a precipitation reaction is before we explain our code.
So basically what our app does, instead of you having to do all the steps to calculate the precipitation reaction, let's say you're doing your homework and you don't know what the answer to a problem is, this will basically help you like find out the answer. And another thing we want to implement in the future is like it gives you the steps on like how to answer the problem. But
so the purpose of this project is to create tools that will be of service to chemistry and AP chemistry students. Our future goal for this app is to make it into a mobile app, and since most students usually have their phones out while they're doing homework anyways. This app will take multiple functions seen throughout the course and basically implement it into an easy to access interface that is available to everybody. As of right now, our program only deals with precipitate reactions and feels fairly clunky with data input. However, with more time, we hope that we can polish out the code, make it easier for the user to input their data, and then develop programs to solve much more complicated programs.
All right, so this was supposed to be like we were going to explain our steps, but because we're kind of running short on time, we're going to just go to our example problem and then explain to us while doing the problem how we're going to actually figure this out. So I'm going to go to the code right now.
All right, so pretty much while we have our input for, you have to drag it to the other screen. So we have a window, pop-up window, and you input all of the, okay. You input both the solutions and the molarity and volume. And what the program will do is it will take that and using the charges of the ions, it will create a balanced equation which will calculate the moles. Yeah.
So,
yeah, go ahead. Alright, so as the sample problem said, we're gonna have like the first solution will be AgNO3. And there's a certain way we have to input this into the program because it parses the string in a certain way, so. And then the second solution is. CaCl2. And then we have molarity and volume. And then it gives us the answer.
All right, guys, so we're going to be giving you guys time signals now. So Teresa over here, she's a senior staff member. She'll be giving you a signal for 1 minute left and then 30 seconds left, like that. And yeah, so we'll be giving you time signals so you know about how much time you have left, and we're timing you to 2 minutes. So next is Team Hummingbird, and on deck is The Soup is Dry.
So we're not very good at AP chemistry, so we just wanted to make a quick, really lightweight game. And Justin did all of the programming, and I just designed everything. Since we wanted to just make it really quick and really small, we just, yeah, actually, you should talk about that part. Yeah, come over here, Justin.
We wanted a simple game.
All right, so this is our first one. It's called Birds. So Charles will just play really quick because he's the only person I know that can beat it over and over again. Okay, he can't beat it. So you're that really tiny hummingbird at the top, and you're trying to reach the flower. And when a bee hits you, you explode and turn on fire. And when you hit the fire explodes and turns on fire. Yeah. So that's very simple. And after that, epilepsy warning, please, this may hurt your eyes, so be careful. Justin, just, I don't know why he did this, but after we did that, we wanted to make something else that was light. So he just made a clicker game, like Cookie Clicker. So you just keep tapping spacebar, and as you get farther in the game, more things flash on the screen.
Space.
Yeah, so once you get to 20, the white flashes become a picture of a bear, and once you get to 30, it becomes pandas barfing rainbows. Yeah. Yeah, so that's what we did.
All right, good job. Next team is The Soup is Dry, and on deck is Alien Invaders.
My name is Karen Zhang.
Hey guys, I'm Peter Huang.
And I'm Ayush.
Yeah, we represent the Soup is Dry from Mission San Jose High School. So we came into this CodeDay a bit too ambitious. We wanted to create a 3D Pokemon game because we all used to play Pokemon in our spare time. But unfortunately, it was, as I said, it was too ambitious. And instead, we just created something in the Unity 3D engine, which Ayush will describe now.
All right, so basically what we made was, I'll just start the game over here, and, all right, so basically as you can see, there's zombies just running around everywhere in the game, and there's a pond over there, and then we tried to make Professor Oak in the back over here. I'll show him to you guys. He's right here, Professor Oak. You see him? Yeah, he's a bit young in this game, but it's okay. All right, so then we got Ash's house on one side, we got Gary's house on the other side, and we got the, you know, this is the average pallet town. We got my boy Professor Oak over here, his laboratory. And I'll just try to get in this lab, and you can check out what's in. So it's really basic, like basic to the max. So we got some books, we got a laptop, you know. Wait, can you guys see it? Oh my god, okay, the resolution is terrible, but like, okay, let me try like increasing the, it's not working. All right, okay, so it's really dark, so you guys probably can't see it, but yeah. We'll go to the closing statement now.
So as we said, this is very ambitious of us because Unity itself took around 5 hours to download on all of our laptops, but we decided that we would extrapolate on this next time because we thought this is a really fun concept that taught us quite a few lessons within the past 24 hours. And that's it. Thank you.
All right, cool. So right now we have Team Alien Invaders, and on deck is Team Jelly Beans. So can we have Team Jelly Beans up here? And Team Alien Invaders? You guys are... All right, cool. And yeah, on deck is Team Jelly Beans. So meet us on the side here. Yeah, when we say you're on deck, please come up. That way we can kind of get you set up so we can move quickly.
Okay, so, how many of you have played like that retro Alien Invader game thing? Like, yeah. So, I pretty much just tried to make that on the iPhone, and yeah, that's pretty much my app. So, you tap to begin, and then, so I can't move right now because I use the core motion API, meaning you tilt the screen to move it, and you can't tilt the simulator. So I can't move, but you tilt that to move, and then you tap, and then you score, and then you have like 3 lives, and you have your score, and yeah, it's pretty basic, but it's great. Yeah.
All right, so now we have Team Jelly Beans up, and on deck is Team Poca. So can we have Team Poca coming to the side here?
Okay, so we made a game and we named it Alien Survival, and you're practically an alien that's going through space. And through each planet, you have to face different challenges and you have to complete an obstacle to be able to move on to the next one. And after you pass a level, you have to go through space and there's comets flying at you and you have to like pretty much destroy them and fly across them, but we didn't get much done, so this is all we have. This is all we have so far. We haven't even completed like one level. So you're pretty much just like going through space and you're like flying and you can shoot. But this is all we have so far and this is it.
All right, so we have next we have Team Poca, and on deck is Team KKKKKKKKK.
Are we allowed to take this off or not?
All right. So raise your hand if you guys played Texas Hold'em before. So our team ran into a problem where we had a deck of cards at CodeDay, but we couldn't play poker. So we decided to make a virtual set of poker chips so you can play poker anywhere you want with a deck of cards.
So we worked on this, and so we made it quite simple. We had a help, so you can see the hierarchy of the poker chips, and you can also see which one you want to input as the chip value, and also you can input the starting value and the number of players. Also, we ran into a bunch of problems with this, and then we had a problem with the emulator as well while we were doing the app, so it was just a complete disaster. We didn't know how we were going to recover from this, but...
Can we just close it?
But because of that, we decided to make a tutorial and where you are Pac-Man, you're shooting poker chips, and not only that, you're killing the ghosts who try to eat you. And basically, how this game goes is that throughout time, first of all, obviously you can see the ghosts get faster. Second of all, they start multiplying so that by the end of the game, your screen should be literally covered in blue ghosts trying to eat you. And it just sees that how long and fast you can live.
Let's go.
All right. Thank you.
All right. So next up is team KKKKKKKKK, and then, all right, and on deck is team 404, Danush not found.
Wait, explain the name first. Okay, so getting this clear, we just spammed a random letter, and both our names are Kevin, so we did K. Yeah. Okay, so basically, we made like this like iPhone thing that if you tap on its head, Siri talks the number of times it's been tapped.
So you go so basically if you want to get really strong, then you need to lift a lot of heavy things. So we made a thing where you just put your phone under the heavy thing and then you connect it to like this pencil which has the touch sensor thing on it. So then you go like this and it just tells you how many times you've tapped it. And then like it says it out loud with like voice like text to speech how many times you're on. So you just keep going like this until you've gotten as many times as you want it.
So that was team KKKKKKKKK. And then do we have team 404 Danush not found here? Do we have team 404 Danush not found? They are not found, yeah. All right, guys, so we need to connect you up. And on deck is team Speeched without an E. Speeched as on deck. All right, so we're having some technical difficulties, so we're going to move on to the next team, Team Speeched, and we'll get back to 404 Danish Northbound when they're ready. On deck is Team Pasta Pals.
Alex, someone said it to me. All right.
Do you need the mic?
You explain the second slide. Thank you. All right, guys, let's get started. So today, we face a problem in society, and that's that speakers in today's world aren't able to practice enough. Like, for example, I'm an impromptu to an extent, and my coach every day tells me, go stand in front of a mirror and record yourself. And while that might be fun and stuff, I won't be able to save a later version for use to maybe compare how I've improved, you know, where do I need help in, stuff like that. So today we present Speeched. Now, as you can see, people, students especially, want feedback when they speak. Coaches, on the other hand, want to know how their students are speaking. We only get 1 hour of practice a week. That's it. So we have to utilize all the time we get to improve our speaking abilities. So we're proud to present Speeched. So speech consists of 3 key things. One, we record the audio of the student while he speaks. So he clicks the record button, we have a timer for him, he records the audio, and we store it into a database so that he can always access it for later use, comparing it to maybe other recordings, other videos, etc. We started off with a very simple concept where it was tri-platform. So we wanted to integrate the Kinect for video recording. Sadly, that didn't happen because we ran into some SDK problems, but this was the basic outline. So we recorded videos with Kinect, stored it in the Parse database. Using the iPhone, we recorded audio, and also we could see the videos we'd already recorded before in the iPhone. And lastly, with the website, we basically had our videos shown there. So here's a quick demo, shouldn't take too long. This is the main homepage of speech. As you can see, a very nice dinosaur who's, I believe, shouting. Impromptu topics, so we created our own random generator, so random topic generator, noun generator, abstract nouns, quotes, and if you click on one, that ultimately leads to your recording, your topic, your time, and then this gets stored into the Parse database. Thank you.
All right, so that was Team Speeched, and now up is Team Pasta Pals. And on deck is Team Functional Reactive Productivity.
What is wrong with this? Wow. Okay, so we are past Pasta Pals, and we have our game. It shouldn't look this bad. And we made a platformer, and we're supposed to be running away from the green slimes. And there is no music. Oh. All right, so this was the beginning. That was our rendered intro, and then we go into our play game, and we have our arena, which is one of our levels, and this was the one that we worked on the most because we have hidden slimes, and they are out to kill you, and when they kill you, you it doesn't come up, but it's supposed to say these nuts, and and we have other levels as well. Show the other. And these levels, we didn't work on as much, but they work. And when you die, all right? And each time you die, you get these nuts, and and that's pretty much it. We have four levels, and they're all working, and we got music and stuff. Yeah.
All right, so now we have Team Functional Reactive Productivity, and on deck is Team Blaze. Do we have Team Blaze here? All right, cool, come on up.
Hi guys, I'm Brian. I call myself Functional Reactive Productivity. So I was speaking with my friend last week, and he said he wanted to make a game. And well, I thought, okay, sure, why not? And we came up with this idea with of this airship battle game. And we thought, okay, we can do this. He told me that he had a couple of graphics artists. Right here, I'm using some placeholders, so yeah. So what I've done is I've built a game where you can shoot stuff and you can fly around like that. And well, he said he wanted to make it an MMO, a massively multiplayer online game. And then, well, I said, well, that's not going to be possible. That costs too much money, too much effort. The thing is that I wrote the code in a way such that the logic was very independent from the rendering. The rendering didn't need any, The logic didn't rely on the rendering at all. So this made it trivially easy to implement multiplayer. So what I've done here is I'm going to just connect, and boom. I have multiplayer. This took 3 lines of code. No, I'm just kidding. It took more like 50, but. But in general, this is a lot less than other games would use because they would have to duplicate code. What I've done is that the programming language I've used, Scala, I've installed a plugin that allows me to convert Scala to JavaScript. So that means that I can share code on both the client and the server. And therefore, I do not have to rewrite a lot of code to do this. All right, thank you.
So now we have Team Blaze, and on deck is Team Octobytes.
Our team, our team is Blaze, and we've created this webpage, and it's actually, we're able to have like non-programmers are able to create their own games using Chrome SDK, which is a software development kit that can be used to create apps for Android and iOS devices. So over here is, as you can see over here on this webpage, you can make 3 types of games, so we have 3 templates.
Okay, so
So we have three templates, as Cyrus said. So we have Brick Breaker, Flappy Bird. Most of you, have you guys heard of Flappy Bird? Yeah. So users can go onto our website, click on Flappy Bird, and they can choose their own files. So for example, if I had just a... Okay, so if we choose a random file, it'll show up on the real-time portion of the website, and you can choose the top pipe as well as the bottom pipes. And basically what we're trying to do is make it easier for people in general to create games and make it a lot easier to publish them without having to know a lot of coding. So basically what I'm doing is I'm adding the images, and people either have these made, or in the future we'd like to make these pre-made as a membership type service. So after that, after they complete the form, they'll receive a zip file, which they'll open, and they can extract this. It's fine. All right, so we have a pre-made demo for you guys here, and it's basically just so it's basically just running Flappy Bird, and you can use your own images to make it customizable and adjust parameters and everything to make it a lot easier to create your own games. Okay, thank you.
So now we have Team Octobytes, and on deck is Team Dank Meme.
Cool. All right, so I made a Terminator app, basically, with the Google Cardboard. So what it does is it takes a live stream of photos from your phone's camera right here, and it analyzes the live stream for any faces, and it gives you the person's position of eyes, their happiness level, and that sort of stuff. So I can show that right here. Hopefully work. Wait, turn around. Hold on. Oh, there we go. It's not, oh, this way. There we go. It's sort of blurry. It's hard to see, but it's easier to see here. But the point is that you can actually point at multiple people. Oh, so no, actually, you mind standing where next to him? Hold on.
You know the light for blind users.
Where are you? There we go. It's much clearer on my screen right here, but it shows you their happiness level and their eye positions and that sort of stuff.
30 seconds.
And so yeah, this was a pretty challenging app to actually make, because I've never used the Google Cardboard SDK before, let alone analyze a live stream of images, and to use a new native API in Android that allows you to detect faces and that sort of stuff. So that's my demo.
All right. So next we have Team Dank Meme, And then after that, we'll be going back to team 404 that you should have found because they're solved. Their issue was solved.
The Gutenberg Post gave us the emoticon. Text messages revolutionized abbreviations. And emojis were created to help us express our feelings in a new way. But what about the truly sarcastic? What about what they need? What about the millions of voices that go unheard every day? Well, today, we have revolutionized the space. We have accelerated our ability to undermine serious conversations, call out a friend, and really confuse old people. So, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Meme Key.
What we're going to do is Ethan's going to send a couple of texts, and we're going to demonstrate how our keyboard works, if he can type fast at all.
And these are real life examples, by the way. Oh, oh. Oh no. I think that may be Impossible Brew.
Copy paste method because iPhones really don't want you to post it into Safari and stuff. So this is Meme Key, and we think this is the future for conversation, texting, and otherwise. Thank you.
Have someone else. What combination did we use earlier to make get the different sounds? Okay. Just type in some combinations like the G. Here. You're gonna stand here and do it. Hey Anderson, come up.
Alright, so I acted mostly as a mentor to these two who really made most of the app. But basically, the app is a note synthesizer. So you can just type in your various notes along with your beat and tempo and the other stuff and the rest, and rest. and then it will play out those sounds for you. Currently, we just use violin, I believe, and or what is it? So yeah, he will play the sound right now. Those are the notes with the rest in between, and then at the bottom right of the screen, you can choose your tempo.
Here, you talk about how the music works. I'll type it in. All right, go ahead and talk about the music.
Okay, so you can choose a few different things like tempo and the length of your notes. So as you see, we have a G and a C, and that was it playing.
This app was both a challenging and rewarding experience for us, because both of us are beginner programmers. But we enjoyed how it turned out, and hope you do too. Thank you.
All right, so now we have Team Jar2M, and on deck is Team Coffee Mates. All right, so technical difficulties again. So we're going to have Team Coffee Mates come on up and present now.
They left
We are part of a club from our school, and as a part of our club, we have to manually enter in the attendance system. And as that can get really strenuous for both the administrator of the club and for the students, we have decided to make it easier by using these Bluetooth that is already on our iPads that we were provided. And the Bluetooth signal will basically connect to the iPad, to the administrator's iPad as well. And by reading that signal, the attendance can automatically be recorded. And then here we have this is the HTML code that we wrote, where you can basically, the user will enter their first name, their last name, and their serial number. And then in addition to that, our code will pick up the Bluetooth devices around the room and then display it in a list, which we don't really have now, but we will show it in the code.
So right now what you see is our menu for our application on Java. So if you press 1, then we're going to register ourselves in. And then we can write our names in, and that's how we And if you can see here, we're using Bluetooth to search for our devices, in which we can use our attendance system. And so we choose a device, and then if we can choose whether if we are a teacher or not. And if you're a teacher, we say yes, or if you're not, we say no. And then you have to say you're a teacher if you're a student. So basically, this was actually a really challenging experience for us because we were originally going to use the HTML code, but then it ended up being too much of a difficulty for us because we didn't really know how web development worked. So we ended up using Java instead. Thank you.
All right, next we have Team Jar 2M, and after that on deck is Team Team.
Live stream within a live stream. Live stream session.
Hi, so we're Team JR2M, and what we produce is something called a Fire of Fifth. So I'm going to ask this again like I did earlier. How many of you are musicians in this crowd? A few of you? Yeah? So if any of you know, the Circle of Fifths is a visual device in order to learn all of your major and minor scales. So what you have here is a visual for all each of the major scales, and they're represented by colors.
So our target audience is to musicians in general to help enhance their abilities. And so as you can see, the MJ is major, MN is natural minor, harmonic minor, and melodic minor. So there are four scales for each of the 12.
So there are four scales for each of the majors. So you have your major, you have your minor, and you have your harmonic minor and your melodic minor. So this is B major. Oh, this is E major right now. I guess we swipe to switch, and we're switching again. So each of them is corresponding to a color. And I think we want to play the sound, right? Do you want to play sound? But basically, each time you press text in one of those areas, it'll play the corresponding key. So hopefully, this will help students to learn their circle of fifths and become better musicians. Thank you.
All right, so now we have Team Team, and on deck is Team the Neuromancers. And guys, just a reminder to keep your presentations as short as possible, running a little bit behind, so try to get done quickly.
Hi guys, I'm Maxime.
I'm Andy.
So when we started CodeDay yesterday, we didn't really have any ideas, but then we wondered, what if chess pieces had feelings? And we worked from there. So we decided to come up with a variation of chess with a morale system based off each kingdom. And so we expanded on that. We added experience systems to level up your units, and then we added special abilities to each unit on the board and totally changed the metagame of chess. So here's like some examples of how we decided to vary up the different units. They have different strength, health values. They have XP drops. They have level ups. They have different effects on your kingdom's morale when you die. And they have various abilities as well, two per unit. So this is a bit of a mock-up of how we would have liked it to look as a finished product. So over here is just a plain start screen. And over here is the actual game. There's a chessboard, individual units. And right here in the blue, you have one of the white bishops selected. And over there, it shows the health stats, level stats, abilities. And then over here, it also shows the stats for each side.
For this project, we used Python mostly because that's the language we are most familiar with. And for graphics, we used Piglet. And we didn't know anything about Piglet, so like we had to spend a bunch of time figuring out how to use it. It's an external library for graphics that we imported. So just to give you like an impression of how far we got with this project, so you can see some of the code in the back, and here is me like clicking. So like, obviously there's no move restrictions yet. Like you have white moving as many. And like, just like, fast forward. You can move pieces wherever you want because there are no move restrictions.
All right, thank you.
All right, now we have Team Neuromancers, and on deck is Team What Do I Put Here?
Our project is a Neuromancer. So before we can talk about our project, we have to know what a neural network is. So essentially, a neural network is a simulation of the brain, or it's a program based on the brain. So as you guys know, brains have synapses and neurons, where neurons do pretty much do calculations, and synapses carry the information throughout the neurons. And sometimes synapses can add some information. So the program's based on that. And then it lets the computer self-learn and do activities based on its new abilities. So neural networks are the key to machine learning, which will be a huge part of the future. It can be used for grouping data and self-learning for computers.
Okay, so now we're gonna show you a quick demo of our site. So first of all, it's all built on a REST API, so if you want to log in, get started. So you can log in with a variety of services using Passport JS, and this entire thing is written in Node.js. Okay, so he's signed in now. So. Now we have a list of your networks, so you can create a network. And you have a couple of options, how many hidden layers, so that's how many layers in between the inputs and outputs, and then the number of input neurons and the number of output neurons. Then you have the number of hidden neurons per layer, and the neuron type and the neuron network, and then you have the neural network name. So usually this demo would work, but since we had a technical difficulty with the computers at the last second, this doesn't work. But basically what it does, scroll up a little bit. So basically what it does is the truth table. So this will, it'll train an XOR network. So
It won't work.
So, the error rate will get gradually lower as you train it more, and you can activate it and get a value in return. Thanks.
All right, so now we have team What Do I Put Here, and on deck is team Cow.
Hi guys, my name is Sahil.
And I'm Mario, and we're team What Do I Put Here? And we made a game called Battleship, or Spaceship Battle. So we'll demo it.
So basically it's a two-player game in which you have to destroy the other person's spaceship.
And there are things like power-ups, which increase your damage or your speed. And there's also a giant planet in the middle, so you have to plan for that. As you can see, the things we're firing are now orbiting the planet. And that was pretty much it.
Thank you.
Now we have team Cow, and on deck we have team Jarvis. And can we also get team Meme Ward up so that we can go quicker?
Hi guys. So we did a game. It's a platform game in Python using the database for Pygame. And pretty much the objective of the game. Or let me start off with like so we did it in Pygame, and I think it's easier if you start off with it.
Okay. I'll now proceed to play the game.
Okay, so there's the objective of this game is we used moving blocks as rects, and pretty much what would happen is the opacity would go down over time every time it updates. So you wouldn't be able to see the block as it comes closer to you, so you have to imagine where it is when you jump over it. And sometimes blocks will lower their opacity when they're near you, or sometimes they'll start from zero and go to 100 when they're right next to you. So you don't know where they are until you lose. Yeah. And you have 3 lives, and
once you hit 0 lives, you die.
Now we have team Jarvis, and on deck is team Meme Ward and team Shockwave.
Okay, hey guys, so our project is School Hub, and many of you may know that schools use School Loop to have all their assignments and test dates in place, but some of our teachers do not really post there and do not really update it. So we really want a social planner or a community-based school website that allows to have all the assignments and tests and due dates in one place based on the community and the students. So we have a website and an Android app for this.
So we have an idea of sub hubs, and basically you can make a sub hub which is the equivalent of a Facebook page. And so, for example, we have Honors Pre-Calculus with Mr. Liu. And so you can create assignments and set due dates. And so when you go to your home page, you can see what specific assignments you have and when they're due.
So this is my first hackathon, so I decided to make a game, and I made a game where you shoot birds at a horde of Yodas with everybody's favorite internet song playing in the background. So yeah, it's called Stop a Gabin. I'm just gonna play it. That's Gabe Newell.
No, it's
Gabe Newell. So I programmed this in C sharp, and all the enemies will jump off and try to follow me down here.
Okay, cool. So that was Team Memor, and we have our final presentation from Team Shockwave.
Hi guys, we're Team Shockwave. We're from Mission San Jose High School, and our product was C-Link. So this is our whole team. Kanaf, would you like to introduce yourself?
Oh yeah, I'm Kanaf Kaluja. I'm from Mission, just like Ishal, freshman. Hi, I'm Jeffrey. I'm from Mission.
I'm Abid. I'm from Mission.
Okay, we know that you're
I'm from Jonas. School. I'm also from Mission.
Oh, wow. Okay. Wow. Okay.
Okay. So our goals for this app is to increase efficiency in daily tasks and be able to quickly exchange contact information by handshake with another person, and then you exchange info through Bluetooth.
Okay, so how it works is, so Arunav and Kanav will demonstrate this. So first the watch will detect a handshake, and then, okay. So basically what we used, we used an accelerometer and a gyroscope to precisely detect whether the person is actually doing a handshake or if they're just, you know, like jogging or like, you know, I don't know. So we focused on we determined the change in the y-axis by using the accelerometer, and that was able to tell us. And we also use the Bluetooth to transfer the contact information from both devices to each other. As you can see, it'll now show up on their phones, the request. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. Thanks.
Weren't you watching the time signals, Israel? You were not.
Come on. All right, so let's have a big round of applause for everybody who presented. So now what we're going to do is we're going to have judges deliberate. So can we have the judges come on up? And they're going to deliberate on who gets the awards. But remember, it's not the awards that matters. And hacking does not end today. Come on, continue. Work on what you learned today and take it further. Create new apps in the future. So the judges are going to deliberate. And in the meantime, we would really, really appreciate it if you could look around, pick up any trash, any water bottles that you don't recognize, any trash around you, please pick it up. Yeah, okay, so we'll take care of downstairs a little later, but for right now, please look around, pick up any trash you see. We would really appreciate it if you could take it and put it in a trash can near you or a trash bag near you. Please stay seated while the judges deliberate. You guys can talk, but we'll announce prizes shortly. All right, guys.
was tired of my lady. We'd been together too long. Like a worn-out recording of a favorite song. So while she lay there sleeping, I read the paper in bed. And in the personal columns, there was this letter I read. If you like piña coladas and getting caught in the rain, if you're not into yoga, if you have half a brain, if you'd like making love at midnight in the dunes on the Cape, then I'm the love that you've looked for. Write to me and escape. My lady, I know that sounds kind of mean, but me and my old lady have fallen into the same old old routine. So I wrote to thank you.
Swing knocked me out with a baseball bat.
Thank you. Yeah, why don't you announce
it? Okay, sure. All right, guys, let's get settled down. We have the judges and we have our decisions ready. So if everyone can take a seat, that would be great. All right, guys, so we're gonna start off by having our judges introduce themselves, and then we'll go and they'll announce each award. So we'll start off with Justin.
Hi, I'm Justin. I'm a student at Gunn High School. I'm a senior.
Hey, everyone. I'm Zach. I'm currently working at a nonprofit called HackEDU, and actually, while I have the mic, I'm going to pitch you. So if any of you had a lot of fun this weekend and want to bring the same culture of building things back to your school, just talk to me. We help high school students start really awesome coding clubs at their schools. We have Layla, Erina, and Jasmine right there, who are actually running a club. I don't know how to pronounce the name of their school, but it's up north with us, so feel free to talk to them as well.
Hey guys, my name is Keezer Hussein, and I go to Kennedy High School.
Hi, my name is Janet Fang, and I go to USF.
And I'm Edward. I was the one who started CodeDay way back in Seattle. So it's great to see everyone here in the Bay Area participating in CodeDay, and everyone from 20 different cities across the country here. So, all right. Everyone here did an awesome job here at CodeDay. All of us as judges were going around earlier today, just seeing the different projects that you created, and we were all so impressed with all the projects. So I think first, Justin, are you doing? Okay, great.
All right, so what we did was we found the top apps and games that we thought were the best overall. So we have the top overall award, which is the one we found was the best overall. The top game, which is game that wasn't the top overall. And the top app, which was the app. And then we also had two special consideration prizes, which were judges' prizes because we thought they deserved special consideration in addition to the other awards. And those are the best presentation and the most useful app. And so we're going to start off with the best presentation. And this was the one that we thought they did a really good job presenting and showing how their app or game worked.
So best presentation goes to Thinkit.
Wait, can we get a photo?
Yeah, you want
your
photo?
Photo? Okay.
Here, so do you want to keep?
Sign out right here. Down here.
Okay, cool.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. And the next one we're going to do is the most useful. So we thought this one was the app or game that we thought was the most useful and we would use in our everyday lives. And
yeah, so this was actually a really hard decision. You guys built some really awesome apps. And when we came in, and games too, but when we came and looked at this app, we realized, well, I could technically do this with Facebook Messenger. There are a couple other keyboards I could do this that could serve similar functionality, but I'm getting a little bit of feedback. But what we ended up deciding was when you wanted to share dank memes, that really required its own keyboard and its own application. So on that note, we're going to give the most useful award to MemeKey. If you could please come up. Yeah, that was awesome.
All right, thank you. The next one we're going to do is the top game. So this was the game we thought that was most creative and also something we would use and play.
So we had quite a few different games here at CodeDay, and we were really excited by so many of them. I remember going through the entire list of games with the judges, and we were just trying to figure out which one that we should keep on the list versus remove from the list of consideration. So I guess out of all the games out there, We were really intrigued by one of them, which had a really incredible use of physics and 3D, and also had a very great, you know, the creator really knew his audience really well. So we'd like to welcome up the creator of Gabe N. Congratulations.
All right, thank you. And the next one we have is a top app. So this was the application that was not a game, and this was something we thought would be interesting to use.
So when considering the best application, the judges had a very hard time determining which one we should choose, which one we should eliminate. And it came down to which one would help who this hackathon specifically was aimed for. And that application is Blaze. Blaze, are you here?
So Blaze was the game creator. So again, we really, really appreciated how Blaze made it really easy for everyone to help to make their own video game.
All right, thank you. And finally, we have the top overall prize. And this was one was something we were had really trouble doing and deciding on.
Yeah, so for the top overall, this was a game. There were a lot of really, really amazing games here. But when we saw this, we just saw how incredibly technically complex it was. We saw just how much fun it looked to actually play. And we also really liked how they incorporated multiplayer. So on that note, we'd like to welcome Functional Reactive Productivity up onto the stage to get the best overall prize. That was awesome. So just to remind everyone, Functional Reactive Programming was the multiplayer space shooter, which was just amazing.
Cool. So if you just hang out up front, we're going to get everyone to take a picture. I'm going to hand this off to Cinderella and close it.
All right, guys. So let's give a round of applause for our judges. So it's been 24 hours since you guys first stepped into CodeDay, or a little bit more since we're running a little late. But you guys, I know a lot of you came in here, beginners, you guys didn't know what you were doing, but excited to code. And now we're really excited because now that we've given you some skills, you guys have learned how to code. And what we're more excited to see, remember, it's not about the prizes here. What we're more excited to see is what you guys go forward and what you guys create in the future. We want to see what you can do with the skills you learned here and what you can create in the future that will really like change the world. Because we believe that you guys are going to be the ones doing that. So I know you're all tired, so I'm going to keep this short. Thank you to all of you for coming to CodeDay. And remember, keep on hacking.
By the way, can I get a round of applause for this organizing team? You're an organizer. Raise your hand right now. Sunil has been leading this organizing team. I came here to the CodeDay just to help out and see how everything was going, and I was really impressed by Sunil. So if you guys are looking to help out with the next CodeDay, go definitely talk with Sunil. All of the organizing team, I believe, are in high school, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so everyone... Okay. Almost all of the people organizing this code day were in high school. So, I mean, this is an event put on by students for students. And I'm really excited about what everyone did here today. And I'm excited to see you guys do more things in the future as well. So, thanks so much for attending Code Day.
All right, guys, if we can have the winners come on up here, we have a few extra things to do.
What? Aw, oh, man, I don't know. Okay.
Janet, we need one photo.
All right, so those of you who have multiple people in the team, and you only have one prize, because we only had one prize, we actually have some stickers that you guys can have. Each person on the team gets some. Yeah. And so where did Russ keep?
Wait, Russ,
I got this.
Russ.
Russ Lang.
You got
guys want to stop?
And then,
who won the other special award?
This is my car. Can you wait like 2 minutes?